Hello and welcome back to my little garage, to my little workshop. Today we're not doing anything to do with motorcycles for a change. Today we're painting a guitar. It's a Yamaha RGX 1200. Very nice piece of kit indeed, which had actually already a really nice finish on it. But a good friend of mine, Jez, who is a customer, he wants something else. It's not going to be anything to do with airbrushing. It's not that kind of project. That's going to be kind of two-tone chameleon kind of effect. But I'll show you how to achieve this as well. Yeah, that will be quite interesting to see how we get on with that. Obviously, first things we need to do with that thing is strip it down. We're going to paint the headstock as well with no logo on it, just the front of the headstock. We're not going to touch anything of the back of the neck, but the whole body needs to be repainted. So I need to take the neck with these two bolts off and then just work on some little bits and bobs. I can see a couple of scratches, couple of imperfections, couple of dents and things over here, so I need to deal with all that, sand it all down, and the biggest job of them all is to fill this pickup slot, pickup hole over here, because the musician won't be using that pickup at all after we finish with it. So we're gonna have just a bridge and a neck pickup, but the middle one he doesn't have any use for anymore, so we're gonna fill it in, and I'll do my best to make it look like a part of a guitar. So without too much bullshit, let me get started with it and see what happens. Rock and roll. Right, so that was easy enough, wasn't it? Now, before I start filling this in, because the customer, Jess, wants these holes in the pickup holders as well, these little screw holes filled in as well as this little large gap over here for the middle pickup, I want to sand it all down to a level that I can see all the imperfections that are around here, or little dings and stuff. And it's pretty much going to be pre-ready for paint. So I'm going to go ahead and do it now. Remove all the dirt, all the dust, all the kind of crap from it. And then we're going to think of the way of filling this hole in over here. So let me do it now. It's not very interesting. It's just sanding. Catch you guys in a little bit. So there we have it, cardboard and pen and paper, piece of wood, jigsaw, and we've got near enough perfect fit. Just like that. A little bit of glue, a little bit of body filler, and this piece is gonna be smooth as you like it. Let's move on. Right, it's the next day and this little piece over here has been glued in place. I put a little anvil on it so it doesn't pop out, you know, because the glue expands inside actually. So that's now glued in place permanently here. I'm going to use some body filler just to make it as smooth as I can. And while I'm at it, I'm going to fill this little hose over here that the customer wanted me to fill. And there are some small imperfections on each side. I'm going to deal with them as well. Let's do this. There we go, that's all filled in, and this little hose as well. I left a little bit like a layer, a little bit on top of the, didn't fit it straight in,
The reason for that is he always sucks in a little bit. The filler always kind of loses its volume when it's drying, ever so slightly. But I will need to fill it in again, I'm sure I will. Once this is all dry, I'm going to sand it down and then fill it again, because there are going to be some imperfections. Hopefully once, maybe two more times, just to get it really perfectly smooth finish, and then we can start putting some base coat on this bad boy. So yeah, join me then.
Right, so here we are. We skip forward just a little bit. I had a couple of days playing with this bad boy, and the guitar, as you can see, is ready now with a base coat. Base coat needs to be black for it. Why? I'll get there in a minute. But the main thing is, there was a pickup hole over here, and as you can see, it's no longer visible, which is a very good thing, because that's what the customer wanted. So the pickup hole has been covered. It's all one uniform piece of a guitar. It's a solid wood over there as well, which for those of you who play any instruments, you know that, you know, obviously a wooden body, depends what kind of type of wood that is, it makes a difference to a sound, you know, to a certain extent. So obviously I didn't fill it in just with the filler, that would be wrong thing to do. There's actually solid wood in there as well, so hopefully in a very minor detail will help to sustain that sound of that beautiful guitar. Well, anyway, what we're gonna do with this thing next, well, let me show you. It's gonna be easier to show you than explain what to do.
Right, so what I've got here and what we're going for, it's not gonna be any airbrushing on this, in this particular guitar. It's gonna be one color. Well, it's a chameleon kind of effect, so it depends what kind of angle you're gonna look at it. It's gonna change a color slightly. Got two-tone pigment here, and that's exactly what I've got here. I got like a chameleon pigment, an essence, if you like. If you don't know if you can pick it up from the camera, but it depends what angle you're looking at it. It kind of changes the color. It's a pearlescent paint. And that is a very, very pigment of it, like a concentrated color, if you like. So we're looking kind of blue, kind of purple, and kind of green maybe on one side. But that's what we're going for. Don't know how well you can pick it up, but maybe inside there you can kind of see the effect that is being, that this paint basically has when you are moving it around. If I zoom you out a little bit, there you go. You can kind of see in a bottle, it's don't know how well it picks up, but you can see the different shades of it. So I'm gonna do my best to mix it up to manufacturer specifications, because I need to be thinned properly. I'm gonna mix it up with some transparent transparent body, some stuff to make it basically stick a little bit better. I've got a spray panel, black panel over there, because the thing is, I never used this type of paint before, so I need to know how it performs. I'm gonna spray it somewhere else first, not on the job, and then I want to get a better idea of what's going on, how to mix it properly, and what mixing ratio needs to be. Obviously I'm gonna follow manufacturers recommendations, but I'm gonna set the PSI right and the nozzle and everything else just to make it work. Once I'm happy with it, I'm gonna spray it on the guitar, and then I'm gonna show you this baby in action, see what happens.
Yeah, that's about it for today, guys. I'm gonna wrap this video, let's call it part one, of the preparation of this little thing for paint. In part two, I'm gonna probably show you the finished product and how the whole thing looks like, because it's gonna be rather spectacular. I need to have a really nice sunny day, go outside and swing this thing around, you know, in the daylight, so you can really see the effect of the chameleon paint. Before we do so, however, as I said, I need to spray the test pattern on my black panel over there, see how the paint performs, how it behaves from my spray gun, and then obviously I need to clear coat the whole thing and give it a good amount of polish, so it's really, really bulletproof. Really can't wait to see that kind of pattern, that kind of finish on the guitar. That's going to be something rather unique. I've never done anything like this before, but it's always the first time. So yeah, stay tuned, guys. Look out for part two of this bad boy, and we'll see whether we can make it any good or not. See what happens. And just on the end of this video, a little update. Virago is off the covers, looking fine, it starts and it's running a little bit better. but I reckon about 2 weeks time, maybe 3 weeks time, I'll be back full time on the Virago build. I'm slowly ticking off this little projects I had going over here. I still got two major projects to complete for the customers. Guitar is one of them, two other bike parts I need to finish off, but I can do some bits and bobs on the Virago in between, because I know you all been looking forward to it, and I'm definitely can't wait to get on this bad boy and get it running after the summer. That will be the best summer yet, I guarantee you, I promise you, I'm not gonna let you down with this thing. So guys, once again, thank you very much for watching. Join me for part two of this bad boy. In the meantime, have a beer and rock hard, and I'll see you very soon.